Hey, what's going on, everyone? My name is Prestige. Thank you so much for joining me on the channel. Today, we're doing some sniping. This is actually some gameplay from the Dark Matter grind, so I hope you all enjoy. I don't really do much sniping here on the channel, so for those of you that are curious, I'm using the Suppressor, the Varix 3, and I think I have Rapid Fire on this one right here, but I hope you guys enjoy regardless. I want to talk about the fallout that we're seeing from the whole fiasco that happened yesterday on social media about SBMM. For those of you that are unaware, SBMM stands for skill-based matchmaking, and I just want to make it abundantly clear that I hate that just as much as the next person. I don't like skill-based matchmaking. It's something that I am not a fan of, and I would definitely voice my opinion on that if there was something to voice my opinion on. A lot of people think that the patch that came out yesterday and then was reverted yesterday think that that was skill-based matchmaking. I think the opposite, because everybody has differing opinions, and I'll tell you why. But once again, I'm not an Activision puppet. I don't have Activision's hand up my ass, and I'm not speaking on their behalf. I'm speaking on my own sanity, because I've seen this happen time and time and time again. Now, for those of you that do not know what skill-based matchmaking is, it's basically a thing that, you know, inside the game that it will take your statistics and match you up against other players that have a similar statistic, which in essence sounds right. It sounds perfect, because once again, if you're somebody that just puts in the game and you have no thumbs and you don't even know how to play it, you don't want to go up against a nade shot pro. I mean, just plain and simple right there. Now, the problem with the whole skill-based matchmaking argument is I've noticed a lot of YouTubers and a lot of people that have influence in the community that simply just ruled it out as it is there. And it put a lot of people in a mindset that really just didn't have the best taste in everybody's mouths, I guess you could say. People immediately just thought, you know, oh, it's there, and they started to play bad. It's similar to the placebo effect that we got from Four Grips in Call of Duty Black Ops 2. A lot of people thought that the Four Grips were working, where in reality they really weren't doing anything. And that's kind of the same sense. I think people forget that we aren't the game developers. We don't see every little thing and every little change that goes on in the background. And I think that that is one problem with Activision and Treyarch. And I will say this, that's a problem that needs to be addressed. We need more transparency when it comes to these updates, when it comes to these hot fixes, because people start to assume things are happening when in reality it really isn't. So when a giant influencer says something is happening, then of course thousands of people are going to believe whatever their favorite YouTuber says. We see it all the time, every single year, just, you know, for example's sake, similar to the whole video idea of the best assault rifle in Call of Duty, the best SMG in Call of Duty. We start to see people saying that as well. We start to see people, oh, you know, the Razorback is the best SMG. The XR2 is the best assault rifle. So I'm going to go ahead and start using this in game, and then eventually everybody follows through and everybody starts to use it because they want to be the best. It isn't a thing of skill anymore. Everybody wants to play people with no thumbs, including myself. You know, I'll be honest with you guys. It would be great to have constant lobbies where people do not know how to play. I could constantly go up against people that literally just run into my bullets and I can get all the free headshots for days. But unfortunately, it is what it is, and sometimes people just get better, and I think people forget that. Now, the one thing that I guess I was kind of confused about was people showing multiple lobbies that they were in and showing that, look, skill-based matchmaking is here. It is real. It's actually happening. But nobody was actually playing in those lobbies. They were going through, searching for a lobby, checking the lobby leaderboards, and then backing out, not actually playing. Somebody, and like I said in the kill-death ratio video, somebody could have a 4.0 kill-death ratio, somebody could have a 3.0 kill-death ratio, but they could be one of the biggest campers in the game, or they can be one of the biggest tryhards in the game. You don't actually know until you actually play the game, and that's the thing that was really bothering me about all of these tests that seem to be coming through with all of these skill-based matchmaking accusations. One more thing that I should point out too while all this was going on is I was actually doing an all-nighter. I was going through, ranking up, trying to get Prestige Master, and I played for a total, I believe, of like 36 hours. I was literally no-lifing it because I just wanted to, and I did not feel any difference. I was there for both patches, and that was it. Like, nothing changed in between. Working on my Dark Matter camouflage, still dropping 50 kill games, still doing good, and that's why on a personal level, I didn't feel any difference at all, and that's why I was saying, you know, I don't know why everybody's accusing the game of skill-based matchmaking. I was just confused. I played solo, a lot of my other friends played solo, and we all experienced the same type of thing. Still being able to wreck people while continuously playing the game and having fun and enjoying ourselves. So I said, finally, let's just turn to David Vonderharr. Let's ask the man himself. Let's see what he did. So he finally got back to us today, this afternoon, actually, on Twitter. And he said here, anything for subs and views. We didn't introduce anything. Connection is king and continues to be so, period. End of conversation. But let me get this out of the way so we can all go back to having fun. First, I love you. I'll be as transparent as I can get away with. We did tune matchmaking. It was tweaked. I said as much on Friday as I tried to whenever we hotfix a game. It did come with consequences we didn't understand in totality, so they untweaked it the following day until we can investigate. What we didn't do is turn on or implement anything new that would deliberately prioritize any criteria over connection, and we won't. I am now going to decorate a tree, watch football, play video games, and then go see a show. Enjoy your Saturday. Talk to you tomorrow. So, that pretty much just says everything that people were thinking was literally just a placebo effect. Everybody was just getting into the mindset that there was skill-based matchmaking. And once again, I don't like it. I don't at all. So if I felt something like that, I would have actually said something. But just from a personal standpoint, I didn't. I really didn't. I'm not lying to you guys. I'm not. Like, a lot of people are going to accuse me, oh, Activision just paid you to say that. No, I have never been paid by Activision, and I'm telling you guys right now that I literally didn't notice anything. And opinions are like assholes. Everybody has one, and everybody's able to spew shit from it. And I just think that it's totally irresponsible of a bigger YouTuber or a bigger influencer to make a video saying that something is hard cold there, presenting it as facts, and it really isn't true. And that's why YouTube can be such a crazy place, because even on yesterday's video, I noticed a lot of people talking about skill-based matchmaking when I had not mentioned anything about it at all. So that is my thoughts. That is my entire experience with the whole skill-based matchmaking thing. Once again, I just wanted to take a moment to talk about this because it's such a huge topic and it's such a bad thing that could happen to the game. We all know what happened with Advanced Warfare. We all know what happened last year with the community. One thing led to another. Things started to get exchanged. And once again, personally, I still enjoyed Advanced Warfare, but I know that a lot of people didn't because of what happened with the game and with the things that were exchanged and with the words that were said. So with all that said, I hope you guys can live at peace now. Whatever happened, happened, and it has been reverted. So if it was skill-based matchmaking, nobody truly knows. But with what Vonderharr's saying, I'd rather believe him over just a big influencer here on YouTube. So anyway, guys, let me know your thoughts down below in the comments section. Let's try to keep it civil down there. If you enjoyed today's video, if you enjoyed the sniping, make sure to click that like button down below. And do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Until tomorrow, my friends, I'll see you next time. Peace.